What's up, you guys? It's Sarah at carnivore.yogi on Instagram. Thank you so much for coming on to my YouTube channel. Please hit subscribe while you're here. So today's video is a short snippet of an interview that I did with Kurt, aka Carnivore Kurt. I'll make sure to link his channel, his website, and his book all below this video. And the full interview will come out next week. So today's May 27th. I'm gonna post that probably a week from today, so in June. So you're gonna wanna subscribe and turn on notifications so you don't miss it. I really enjoyed this conversation and think it's relevant to women and men. The conversation about testosterone, this hormone, is very necessary for all of us. So I think that men and women can both benefit from Kurt's knowledge on this topic. I also wanted to let you guys know that, in case you didn't know it, Kurt and I are not doctors or medical professionals. This is not medical advice and should not be taken as such. And the last little thing here, I wanted to mention one of my sponsors, Let's Get Checked. I'm going to put a link below this video in the information section for a testosterone test that you can actually take from the comfort of your home. So that will all go below this video. Make sure you check out the information section. And thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to like and comment. Have a really awesome rest of your day.
As you mentioned earlier, I have done my blood work 3 times. So I've looked at my like entire panel, and fortunately, because I'm good friends with Paul and I've got a couple doctors in the family, I can just email them, and I have health insurance through my company. So they cover most of the testing and I can go and get my blood work done. And I've looked at my testosterone levels 3 times. When I started Carnivore, I was at, I think, like 650, which is pretty decent for a 35-year-old male. And then when I actually was 34, and then when I was 35, I tested again and I was doing OMAD and I was doing 1 meal a day, and I got so lean, Sarah. I got like down to like probably 6% body fat. Wow. I mean, it was like, you could see like almost see my liver, you know, it's like, you could see everything down there. Right. But yeah. I was weighing 10 pounds lighter than I am today. And wow. I mean, I'm not like, I don't carry a lot of weight on me right now. And like, you know, before I was like, just so, I was so lean, and it was good for performance and convenience. I will say that, but I noticed that my sex drive and my energy overall and my strength was lower. I was 10 pounds lighter, dude. I didn't have as much muscle on me. And so,
And then your testosterone levels were low when you tested.
Yeah. When that happened, I tested my testosterone and I was at 315. And that's pretty much at the bottom of where you ever want to be. And you really don't even want to be there, you know, Paul and I were doing labs, and he's like, your testosterone's super low. You know, I don't know why. And I was like, I think I know why. And so I started experimenting and I added in, more fat. I added in way more calories. I went from like 1800, 1900 calories a day up to like 2500 calories a day. And I did that by adding in a breakfast. I just completely got rid of OMAD. And the thinking behind that was that, like, you know, nature probably downregulates our reproductive and anabolic growth type processes in our bodies when we have less food coming into us.
Oh, yeah.
And so I probably was like activating some longevity stuff and like, you know, going for like all for like just the stuff that just lowers your metabolism and your energy levels, but I wasn't getting it. And so I did that for like, what did I do that? I think I did 6 weeks. No, I did it 3 weeks. So I upped my game by like adding a new meal, upping my calories. I focused on getting better sleep. And at the time I was dating like a Latin gal and she was waking me up in the middle of the night and like going out all the time. And I just wasn't getting like consistent, like thorough sleep. And so I focused on my sleep game. I focused on eating way more calories and I bumped my testosterone. And next test I did, same time of day, pretty much the same day, same sort of like routine. I'd wake up at like 8 a.m. and wait till 11 a.m. to test. So, because I know it fluctuates a lot throughout the day.
Yeah, and if you like work out beforehand, doesn't that make it go up a little bit?
So yeah. I didn't work out. I never work out. Usually I don't do blood work after I work out for at least 2 days. So I give myself like 2 full days of like, okay, just walks and like low intensity activity, because your hsCRP inflammation markers can go up. Yes. Your a lot of your hormones can get tweaked a little bit, and I want to try to see what the true kind of resting levels are. So yeah. So I tested that again, and my testosterone went to like 900, which is like,
wow,
like amazing. It was like tripled from what it was.
Yeah.
And then I did a test again about 6 months later. Let's see. I think I was in June when I tested at the 900, and then I tested again in October. So what is that? 5 months, four or five months later. And it was at, seven, like in the 700s. So it was still really strong. And for me, anything above 600, I'm totally fine with. I don't need to be at 1,000 or like, you know, like this crazy bodybuilder level, but I want to see it in, I want to see it above 700 most days. Like I would like to see it up in that level.
Yeah. And I you know, I think with women, like we were saying kind of before we went on camera, we have an alarm. It's like, if we don't get our cycle, we know that the sex hormones are not functioning properly. And I just talked about it in a live video that I did about a week ago, a live stream of, you know, talking about gaining a little bit of weight due to stress and all that. But kind of, you know, with the weight gain, I actually got my sex drive back, which had been gone for a really long time. And my testosterone has been non-existent for a really long time. But I've been doing a really high fat carnivore, doing a lot of the raw Iberico pork fat from white oak.
Nice. That's
like my jam, like, because I haven't been able to get suet anywhere. And I don't really like suet from white oak. So I just get the Iberico pork belly, cut off the meat part for my family, and then I just save the fat for myself.
Nice.
And I quit doing all fasting. You know, I had done a lot of fasting before, and I think that what fasting does for a lot of people is it down regulates those sex hormones. And mm-hmm. you know, maybe you lose some weight, maybe, you know, again, you get real lean, but if it's kind of like taking a shortcut, I think, you know, it's like you're cutting off your body's ability to reproduce. And it is a longevity thing. I mean, you don't, as a woman, you don't want to lose that ability to ovulate and have a cycle. And I see a lot of women struggling with that. And like with men, it's kind of more of a silent thing. So what happens, did you feel when your testosterone was lower in that 300 range? I know you said you noticed your sex drive wasn't as high. You had a little more low energy. What other symptoms were you kind of dealing with at that time?
Well, I mean, the big thing was I lost weight. You know, I lost weight and I got very lean, which isn't always a bad thing. But in this case, it was like, you know, when you're getting to 5%, 6%
yeah.
body fat, I think we really want to be, for men, around 10 most of the time. And then for women, it's, you know, 15 to 20, or well, 10 to 15 for men, probably between 18 and 25 for women is like a good sweet spot. And so the big thing I saw was, just lower strength and size. And yeah, those were like the big signs for me.
Yeah. Do you do any kind of fasting right now, or are you still more so doing like the breakfast and kind of more frequent meals?
I try to eat in the morning, but I often forget to like eat until like 10:30, 11.
Okay.
So, you know, I don't get my breakfast as early as I'd like. So that's one thing I'm focusing on, but so I'll usually have dinner and I'll have my last meal at like 7, and then I will wait until 10 o'clock in the next morning. And I usually try to get my breakfast in by 10. Lately, my sleep schedule has been a little different. I'm kind of playing with that. Like ideal, if you want to like go extreme, I think the ideal scenario is kind of like an hour after sunset, kind of get into bed. And then, you know, an hour before sunset, you're up. And then, you know, for me, I don't know if you've read like Power of Now or
yeah.
any of the chronotyping. So like, depending on your chronotype, if you're a lion, like I typically kind of fall into, then you would eat breakfast right away.
Yep.
And then have a big lunch and then maybe a light dinner. Mm-hmm. But socially it doesn't fit into like a normal life. It's like,
it's really hard
and it's not worth it. I mean, I've tried that and like you get so rigid and I mean, yeah. if you have health problems, I think it's worth it. But you know, for me, I'm pretty healthy. And so you know, my social health was suffering, is, you know, is what I'm saying. And so that doesn't mean I go out and like, I want to go super late into the night, but yeah, I'm typically eating, on a window from like 10 a.m. until about 6 p.m., 6:30 p.m.